Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to learn about find command in Linux systems. So find command is one of the most useful command in Linux systems. Using this command, we can search and locate list of files and directories based on some conditions. So let's see how it works. So first let me show you. I have created some dummy files and folders. Let me show you this. So I have few files here. Okay, so I will run my first command, find dot, say I want to find the file.txt. Okay, so what this command will do, this find command, and then after this a dot signifies the current working directory. It will search for this current working directory and the sub directories through this current directory, and it will search for this file name, file.txt. okay, and it will, if this file will be found, then it will give the output as this, that yeah, this is the file in this directory. Suppose we want to find, say, this abc.txt, then it will give you that in this path in the directory work the file abc.txt is present. So in this way you can simply give the name. Minus name is the attribute which signifies the name of the file. Okay, you can also do one thing. You can also specify the type, like minus type is another option you can use. Minus type f signifies the file. It will search for file with the name file.txt. So this will give the same output. You can also give the type as d, so it will look for directories. D stands for directories. So as there is no such directory with the name file.txt, let me type this. I will now try to search the directory with the name work. Okay, so now you can see we have got the output as slash work, means we have this in this kind directory. Okay, this is the way you can search for some files or directories. Next we will see other command, like suppose you want to, I want to search some file, okay, but I don't know the name. Maybe I want to list down all the text files. So you can simply write minus type f, means I'll search for files, then minus name, then the file name. So I will simply put a regular expression here, means this signifies anything, star signifies anything, ends with .txt. So it will list down all the .txt files. As you can see, from this current directory, let me print the current directory. Now the current directory is this Unix. Under this directory, it will search for all the text files, and even in the subdirectories, like inside here we have two more directories, work and docs. So inside work we have some text files, so it will print those files also. So find command searches for its current directory and its subdirectories inside it. Okay, let me create the terminal. So yeah, now I will show you another command, like find dot, it will search for the current directory, then minus empty. What it will give you, it will give you all the files and directories which are empty. As you can see, we have some files and directories too. So this doc is empty, this directory is empty, as you can see. That's why it gives, in this case it gives these two files name and this directory's name. It signifies that all these things are empty. You can simply specify the type also here. Like suppose I want to find only the empty directories, then what will happen? It will simply give you type D. D stands for directory. It will give you this. If you type F here, it will give you the empty files. Okay, in this way you will find, you will be able to find the empty files or directories. Now next we will see how to execute any Linux command on the files we found. Like suppose you want to find some file and you want to search for a pattern. Like say I type this command, type F, then name, then I will search for all the text files. Okay, in this text file I would like to say, I would like to grep minus I will like to grep this pattern engineer. Okay, what this will do, this will first search for text files in the current directory and subdirectory, and then it will minus execute allows you to execute any Linux command on the files, which will be the output of this portion. Okay, in on the files you can simply execute this command grep, and this closing and closing and this open and closing braces is required, and then the slash and then the semicolon. Now this will allow you to search this pattern. So as you can see, it gives me these three lines. Let me show you where it was present. CD work, and then here we have some files. Then if we cat this file, in this file we have something like this. So it picks up all the lines which contains the engineer as a pattern. Okay, so I hope you understood how this exec command works here. Now let me clear the terminal first. I'll show you some other commands. Now suppose say I want to remove some empty files, like not empty files, suppose you want to find some file and you want to remove them. What you can do, you can simply write find, then type. You can also give some path. Suppose you have you know some path, then you can give some path here, and then you can execute the find command. That's okay. Okay, but I'm now searching it in the current directory, so I won't give any path. I can simply put dot, then minus type, then minus name, and then the file. Say I want to remove some file.txt. Okay, once I find this file, I will simply remove exec rm. Minus I, if I give minus I, it will ask for permission, and a prompt will come. Let me show you. Okay, so this command, what it will do, it will simply search for this file and then it will execute the rm command on that file. Oh, we are in the work folder, so I don't think that we have this file.txt here. So let me go behind. So here, as you can see, we have this file here. I will try to execute that command, previous command. Yeah. Now this is asking, just because I gave minus I, it will ask me that if I want to remove this file. If I type Y, then it will remove. As you can see, the file has been removed. So in this way you can search for files and you can even remove or execute any command you want to execute. Okay, so now we can see say you want to search for the files which has been modified in last 50 days. So how can you do that? Let me first clear the terminal. So suppose I want to find from the current directory minus type f name. No, we don't need to do the entire thing. We can simply go for like minus this, then we can simply write minus m time stands for modified time. Okay, then the number of days, like say last 50 days I want to search for the files which has been modified in last 50 days. Okay, so it's giving me these files as I have modified this recently. So these are the output which has been modified in last 50 days. Again, if you want to check for last 30 days, you can again give it minus 30. Okay, so suppose you want to find those files which has been accessed in last 50 days, then it will be minus a time. Okay, say in minus a time I want to search for the files which has been accessed in last 50 days, then you can run this command. Okay, suppose you want to find something, you want to find some files which has been modified in last 50 to 100 days, then you have to do something like this: minus m time, then plus 50, and then minus m time, minus 100. So what it does, it will show you it is like searching the files from 50 to 100 days. Like the previous 50 day will be will not be searched, then after previous 50 day, say from 51 to 100 days, say in the last 50 to 100 days, okay, not in the last 50 days, after that 50 to 100 it will search. Then as you can see, it is giving no files because this current directory does not contain any file which has been modified in last 50 to 100 days. So in this way you can also narrow down your search, like you want to search for some specific time, so you can basically give a range here. Okay, and then you can search for the files or directories you want to search. So we also have a command for change. Suppose you want to find those files which have been changed in last 1 hour, so you can use cme and then minus 60. So it signifies that it will search for all the files which has been modified in last hour or in last 60 minutes. So it will give you something like this: as these files have been modified by me in last 60 minutes, so these are coming as output. Say you want to do something like minus c mean, say 200 from this, so it won't give anything. So I am basically looking for 60 to 200 minutes, means not in last hour, before that 200 minutes. If I have modified any file, then it will give me that output. So similarly you can define the range here. Okay, so yeah, these are some basic find commands which are useful for the beginners as well as for the experts. So yeah, that's it for today. If you like the video or and you get something from this video, then please like my video and also subscribe to our channel and also share this video with your friends. Thank you for watching.